Alrighty, here we go. Game three in the Pox deck. Our opponent wins the die roll, so probably going to be playing first. Just a guess. Not an amazing hand, but we'll keep it. We have tons of lands, so I mean, we have Urborg and two wastelands, so that essentially will act as another. Oh, goblins. This should be fun. Oh, excuse me. I actually saw a goblin deck the other day at the Legacy event. It's kind of funny. So Marsh Flats, Inquisition. If you had, I'd love to take the ring there, but I can't, sadly. However, he does have two Barbarian Rings, which means two Wastelands, two Barbarian Rings, boom, boom. Skirk Prospector, it's okay, so I'm just going to write this all down in 1 second. Alright, so we're going to take the War Marshal here. That is going to be the most annoying one for us. Yeah, run Chalice and Goblins. Only if you ever pile out first. Yeah, I can't get Ringler though. So, I'm just going to play two rings here. If you like to, oh my gosh, two vials. That's going to be a pain. Why does he not play his, the Skirk? It's just odd to me. Trying to think here. I'll play a tomb and cast a curse scroll and pass the turn. Wasteland, but obviously it looks like he's just going to go with the vile route, so we don't really need to worry about the rings right now. Better to get our Liliana out than to just, you know, delay ourselves while not really getting any advantage over our opponent. And he does have Lightning Bolt, but so next turn, play Liliana, hopefully draw out his Lightning Bolt. That's what I would do in his situation. That'd probably be best. So boop, boom, boom, Liliana, we'll discard our Nether Spirit by activating the ability. He will have to basically Lightning Bolt and attack with the Skirk if he wants to. Oh, swords? Dang, he must be playing Splash and White. It's weird, usually goblins will splash black, but you know, whatever. To each his own. Whatever works. It's all good. It's all good. Dang. Is he gonna... Yeah, he's gonna sacrifice the Skirk to get his Ringleader. Yep. Hopefully he doesn't draw. He gets the War Marshal. So, play that out. That's fine. Not too worried about little War Marshals running around. And we know he has a Lightning Bolt in hand, so that's that. And we'll get our Nether Spirit, which is rockin'. We'll get rid of the Lightning Bolt. Actually, I'm trying to think here. So if I play a Wasteland, two, three, we'll have him discard his Lightning Bolt, and then we'll get rid of our Catacombs. Then, play Sensei Divining Top. And that way we can use our cursed scroll to kill one of his guys. So we'll wait till his turn, obviously. That way he'll attack in. That is nice though, they only hit a War Marshal with his Ringleader. Otherwise that probably would have been trouble for us. So ooh, even better he doesn't pay the Echo cost. What are you casting? Three? Okay, even better. So this is what's going to go down. He is going to attack with everyone, obviously, because that would be awesome, except for Chieftain, because he doesn't want to lose it. Oh, don't see it. Don't see the Cursed Scroll play. So he's going to try to get rid of my Liliana. What we're going to do is shoot down the Goblin Chieftain by using our Smallpox and the Cursed Scroll. We'll block the Ringleader with the Nether Spirit, and that way our Liliana survives. And he basically just has two tokens on the battlefield. Seems good to me. Oh, he's gonna use the Barbarian Ring. However, that is actually really good for us. See what we have on the top of our library. Instant Blood doesn't do much here. It'll be good later. Trying to think what would be the most optimal play here. Yeah, I think the Smallpox play is the best. I mean, sure, yeah, we lose a guy. Let's see, because this one. But he'll come back. He'll have to sacrifice one land. But then I can wasteland his last remaining land, so that seems pretty good to me. Yes. And he has 1/1 token out right now, so I mean he does have the Aether Vials, so he can basically play almost any goblin he wants. Well, the most impactful goblins besides like Lackey, but obviously he doesn't need Lackey right now. My voice is going out. So what I'll do here, since I'm not worried at all about that one, I'll get a Mire so that way we can shuffle up our library and get a new batch of cards on the top. So definitely bringing in the Python Needles next game. That will be a big one. Alright. Passes. We'll bring our spirit back from the graveyard. Yes. Draw our Mire. Shuffle it up a little bit. Look at the top three. Why? Because we have nothing else we can do right now. Yeah, because that's not casting. That's kind of lame. So, going to draw. Oh, no, never mind. Not worried. We did our Mire already. Whew. That's right. Got to remember these things. So, sharpshooter. Oh, great. That guy's annoying. But he doesn't really have a sacrifice outlet yet, so Hopefully, fingers crossed. You know, Wasteland. Alright. That's fine. That is just dandy. Why? Because we got another swamp on top. Yeah, we're gonna kill that. And he can go ahead and shoot our spirit because, you know what? It's just gonna come back next turn, so bring it. I'm just gonna do that. Okay. That's right, because that's what. Yeah. Do. Get that. I'm gonna look at the top three first. So. Don't need Nether Void here. We're just going to use Chris Scroll next turn and shoot down his sharpshooter because that guy is very annoying. Hopefully we can keep him down on lockdown. Had he not had the vials, I would have kept the Void, but yeah, what do you do? So, we're going to draw our swamp. Name swamp here. And then we'll attack for two. Oops, yep. Oh well, what can you do now? And that way we can look at our top at the end of his turn. And hopefully he just doesn't draw anything. If he gets a ring later though, that could be very bad. Okay, I got it. I'm in a game. Alright. So, obviously not playing anything probably means he either has a burn spell, or he's waiting till the end of our turn to play a goblin. Don't need two Crush Scrolls just yet, so. I'm gonna draw the swamp. I'm just gonna get another swamp. Okay. So just send me one text, please. So what I will do is I will play the swamp. Use the top to draw a swamp. That way we have the ability to Wasteland and Curse Scroll. And we will attack with another spirit. And that way we'll just start getting more mana. So, he doesn't play anything anyway, so that works out for us. So he has a Wasteland. We're going to take our Mishras. Good choice, good choice. Seems like the best option, so shoot two damage at him. Swamp, of course, is what we'll name. Bring him down to 11. Take him down to 9. Play the top. That way we can look and use its ability to draw a card if we need to and activate the Curse Scroll. So. Do. Let's see. Does he have nothing? So, activate the top. Inquisition. Seems good. So yeah, I'm not gonna do the top's ability. I will wait right now. Play Inquisition. And yeah, he's just gonna concede. So let's go on to game two. Perish is no good. Spring Darkness helps us. Nether Void's not good. Abyss is good. Python Needles all the way. What do we want to take out? Pox is not that awesome against this matchup. Sinkhole is good, but yeah, it's hard. This is a hard one to sideboard out. And I think that'll be it. We want the Innocent Bloods just in case he gets out turn one lackey. I mean, we didn't see any, but that does not mean that he doesn't have him. So, so he mulligans a six, which is good for us. I'm trying to think. Which play do I like the mostest? We'll see it. We draw. Oh. What play can... Okay, so this is even better. I was hoping for a second Dark Ritual. That's the only way this hand would have got better. So we'll play him to Turok. Doof. Get rid of Chieftain, Ringleader. And we'll play Smallpox. Getting rid of one more card, putting our spirit in the graveyard, and getting rid of his mountain. And rid of his Goblin Matron. That way, yeah, it's fine. We get our spirit next turn, lay down our factory, and our Urborg. Hindsight, it probably would have been better to Smallpox first. That way he discards the card that he didn't want, but... luckily, I'm totally happy with those two targets. Those are awesome. Oh, and as if we couldn't ask for a better top deck, we get a top. So, bam! What now? What now? Man, this box deck's doing really good today. Definitely liking the addition of the tops and the fetch lands. So, Wastelands are Mishras. That's fine. That's all dandy. Wasteland, eh, no good. We'll play our Urborg, and we'll wait to the end of his turn to look at the top of our library, since it won't do us any good on our turn. That way we can semi-fake that we might have something in our hand. Matron. Ooh. So he's going to get Ringleader next turn, play the Vial. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we can get a Python Needle. Just saying. But since I said that, I know we won't. Okie dokie. So, what we'll do is we'll get the Delta. Pop the Delta, go get a Swamp. I look at the top three. Yeah. No Python Needle. Sad day. Swamp on bottom. Mishras. And then Liliana. So, just pass the turn. Since that's basically all we can do. Hopefully he doesn't get any two drops. I don't know what he draws. Maybe he'll draw land. So hopefully... we'll see, maybe it doesn't get a 3. So, plays the Ringleader, obviously. And gets absolutely nothing. which is actually super good for us. If he wants to attack the ringleader, go right on ahead. I hate this chat window. Wish Wizard would fix this. It's not good having to undock your chat so you can see what people are saying. Play the Wasteland, and Liliana. And we'll have each player discard a card. No idea what he has in his hand. Another Goblin Ringleader. Ooh, so almost out of Ringleaders. That's good news for us. Just going to play defensive for a little bit. No reason to attack with our Spirit. We're not going to get any advantage by doing that yet anyway. Another Vial. Man, what I would do. Oh, and he concedes the game. So there you have it. Game 3 versus Goblins. I will see you all in round 4. Thanks for watching.